We were discussing this relaxation of the one-year clause to file any petition under section, under any of the sections of the Hindu Marriage Act. If such petition is to be filed by divorce by mutual consent, then parties have to wait, number one, for 1 year to file a petition, and number two, further 6 months after filing a joint petition under section 13B. So, when the law permits this relaxation of 1 year, Hindu Marriage Act itself makes the provision for the relaxation. But in respect of section 13B, the statutory period of 6 months, the Hindu Marriage Act is silent. It does not confer any power to the court to relax it. When other period of 1 year, in respect of other period of 1 year, a provision has been made for the relaxation, conferring power upon the court, and not conferring the power on the court in the same manner in respect of the 6 months statutory period under section 13B would mean that legislature never intended that such period of 6 months be relaxed. So courts are not competent to relax this 6 months period. However, different high courts and the Supreme Court also have relaxed such period. Because these courts are the constitutional courts and have inherent powers to do justice. So they are the court of justice, and family court or a district court is a court of law. So district court is not having, or a family court is not having, express power. But the High Court and the Supreme Court so many times have granted even the divorce in a writ petition. Suppose litigation is pending before lower court and both the parties have come before the High Court in connection with any order, and in the High Court or the Supreme, before Supreme Court, they agreed to have a divorce by mutual consent. Now remanding back or remitting back the parties to appear before lower court to go through these proceedings would mean again there may be occasions and chances will be higher and higher to have some quarrels and not materializing the compromise whatever they have decided. So in that case, for doing a complete justice, the Supreme Court and the High Courts have granted the divorce petition, divorce in writ petition. Another highlight I would like to suggest to note would be camera proceeding. Proceeding have to be conducted in camera, means outsider will not be permitted, restriction on the publication of the proceedings. Third highlight would be third highlight would be the party himself cannot take the advantage of its own fault. which was that section 23 or something else? There is one section I am just forgetting, under which a party cannot take the benefit of his own wrong. I will let you know. Section 23 deals with. Just go through section 23. Yes, 23. Another special highlight to be remembered will be the courts have to make attempt to reconciliate the matter on the first hearing. As in the CPC also, if you remember, the section 89 of the CPC, talking of the ADRs, a court before proceeding further on the first day of the hearing have to make attempt for the mediation, reconciliation, ADR mechanism to resolve the dispute before proceeding further. The same has been made compulsorily under section 23 clause 2, that court has to make endeavor to resolve the dispute through ADR mechanism. ADR means alternative dispute resolution, like mediation, conciliation, what is that?
Arbitration.
These all are the modes of. But there is one restriction of this reconciliation, adopting the ADR mechanism. The condition is that if it is a case of the conversion, if a person has become the Mohammedan and parties are trying to reconciliate, no reconciliation is possible because he has converted. If there is unsoundness of mind, if it is a case of incurable form of leprosy or a venereal disease, or one spouse has renounced the word. If these four, section 13 may clause 2, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th, so 2nd to 6th clauses ke ground pe agar divorce petition hai, to reconciliation karane ki avashyakta nahi hai. Another special highlight, where this petition can be filed, the family court has come into existence and petition can be filed in a family court, and section 19 of this act, Hindu Marriage Act, also makes it clear it can be filed in a district court. Where can it be filed? The marriage was solemnized, or where the respondent at the time of presentation of the petition resides. Some law has been changed. Now it has been made that where the petitioner resides can file. So far as I remember, some law has come on this point, a petition for the divorce can be filed where the petitioner resides. Where the respondent resides, it's a general rule, it is the same rule adopted in the CPC. Where the defendant resides, the suit can be filed in the territorial jurisdiction. I've been keeping it open for discussion on this point. We'll see it tomorrow. One or two more special highlight of this act would be that documentary evidence cannot be refused on the ground that it is not a registered or a stamped one. General rule is that where the law requires the registration and the stamp to be paid, a document can be made admissible in evidence only when these requirements are fulfilled. But exception has been made for a documentary evidence produced in a matrimonial dispute. Custody of minor, custody of the children, section 26, you have to remember, custody, maintenance and education of the minor children has to be decided by the same court, and time period would be the maximum 60 days from the date of service of notice on the respondent. And this is also a golden rule for deciding the custody of the minor. The paramount consideration for deciding an application for custody would be the best interest of the minor. No hard and fast rule can be made to whom custody should be made. No specific terms can be expressed. We were discussing the enforcement of the decrees, section 28A. It says that decrees under this act shall be enforced in the same manner as decrees passed by the courts in original civil jurisdiction. So order CPC and the order 21 would be applicable. How the proceeding under this act will be governed? It will be governed as per procedure prescribed by the CPC. And decree will be enforced under order 21, and under order 21 the modes have been given for a decree, only one decree, that is the restitution of the conjugal right, that can be enforced. And not only that, there may be decree in other types also. If it is a divorce, then no need for enforcement. But if it is a decree for permanent alimony, we have left it section 24 and then 25. 24 says that during the pendency of this litigation, if petitioner is not having sufficient means how to carry on these proceedings, she or he can move an application for maintenance, and court can grant it. But when court is going to decide a final order, or divorce or whatever it may be. Then section 25 makes the court enable to decide the permanent alimony. It can be one time, it can be periodically, because under Hindu Marriage Act also, husband or the wife is bound to maintain his or her spouse if he himself or herself is not able to maintain. Even after the divorce, but till they remarry. So we will take this maintenance aspect separately.